Hello, my name is Brian Beach, and I am the worldwide tech leader for builder experience at AWS. Today, we're going to discuss how to create, test, and deploy a serverless framework application using Amazon CodeCatalyst. CodeCatalyst is an integrated DevOps service that provides you with all the tools you need to build, test, and deploy your application. This includes the CI/CD pipeline, as well as the project management tools and development environments needed to collaborate with the other developers on your team. If you're unaware of Amazon CodeCatalyst, it launched at reInvent 2022. So let's get started. I don't want to spend a lot of time on slides. I want to jump right into a demo and build a serverless framework application from scratch. So let's jump right in and do that. Okay, I'm already logged into Amazon CodeCatalyst, and I'm logged into a space. A space is a way to organize your projects. Maybe a business unit within your organization has created a space, and they've invited multiple members that are collaborating on multiple projects. So to get started, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new project here for our application. Okay, and you can see right away that it's offering me a series of blueprints. Blueprints are essentially starting points. And we have blueprints for most common AWS tools and technologies, including the serverless application or SAM framework for serverless applications. There's also projects for single page web applications or common backend and front end web frameworks here that you'll find. But there isn't one for the serverless framework. I'm sure at some point we will create one, but at the moment there isn't a serverless framework application. So rather than starting from one of the many starting points, what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to start from scratch. And we'll look at creating a project without a blueprint, and we'll just build it up from the ground. So I'm going to create a new one. We'll just call this serverless framework demo. Let's create this project. And this is essentially going to create an empty project within CodeCatalyst for me. All right, so it's gone and it's done that. And you can see here, I've got multiple things. I've got issues. The issues is where I would do my project management, manage my backlog, and set up Kanban boards, things like that. Under code, obviously, this is where we're going to find our source code. And then under CI/CD, these will be our workflows for deployment. And we'll look at each of these as we progress. To get started, though, let's go into code, and I'm going to create a source repository. All right, there's no repositories here. A project can have multiple source repositories, and I'm going to add a new repository. And I can create one here, or I can also link an external one. So for example, if I already have a GitHub repository that I want to use, I could have done that as well. But I'm just going to create a repository right here in CodeCatalyst. And again, I'll just call it serverless framework demo, and I'll create that. Give that a couple seconds, and it will go off and create a new repository for me. As you would expect, the only thing in this repository right now is just a README file that's boilerplate. Okay, so now that we have a repository to work in, the next thing I need to do is start my development environment in order to work here. And so what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to come right up to create dev environment, and I've got multiple options. I can work in AWS Cloud 9 or Visual Studio, one of the JetBrains IDEs. For this demo, I'm going to use Visual Studio Code. So I'll do that. And I'm just going to work right in the main branch. I'm not going to create a feature branch for this demo. We'll keep it really simple. And so I'll go off and create that. Okay. And so that's going to start Visual Studio. And the AWS toolkit for Visual Studio is going to kick in. And so I want to take a moment and explain what's actually happening here. I am not just cloning this repository local onto my machine. Okay, you can see that actually what Visual Studio is doing is it's opening a remote connection to a dev environment that's running in AWS. All right, and that's an important distinction. So I'm not actually editing this code on my local machine. I'm editing this on an environment within AWS. And this is really powerful because it allows me to have multiple environments for different projects. And that resolves a lot of common issues with things like version conflicts. If you've got multiple versions of Python installed or something like that, you know what a hassle that can be. Okay, so my dev environment is up and running. Let's come in and I'm just going to, within this project, I'm going to install the serverless framework. So I'll do an npm install serverless, and we'll let that install. I should note, if I had started from a blueprint, if I were using, say, the SAM framework rather than the serverless framework, the blueprint would take care of all of this for me. So the blueprint can include all the tools that are necessary that you want installed in your dev environment. That way, when you've got a new developer that starts on your team, they're ready to go immediately. As soon as they clone the project and start their new dev environment, all the right tools will be installed for them. And all of that is codified as part of the blueprint that you're using. Okay, so the serverless framework is now installed. And then I just simply run serverless. And I'll go through the wizard to create a new project. All right, and in this case, I'm going to do an HTTP API. We'll make this just a really simple RESTful API. So I'll select that. I'll leave the default name. And it's going to go and download and scaffold that project for me. And here it's asking me about my AWS credentials in order to deploy this. I'm going to skip this because I'm not going to deploy it from my dev environment. We're going to create a CI/CD workflow to deploy this in a minute. Okay, so if we come in and take a look, you can see it's created this new folder for me where my project lives. And there's two important files here. So the first thing we've got is in the index file, this is the code that is going to run inside the serverless application. This is going to be a Lambda function. All right, and this is what's going to handle the actual implementation of that serverless function. Obviously, this is super simple at the moment. What I want to do is let's just update this. And I want, rather than just the default message, let's customize that a little bit. And I will say, let's say, hello from Code Catalyst, right? Instead of just a simple hello world message. All right, so that's the first file. The second thing that it's created for me is this serverless.yaml file. And this is the file that is describing my project, okay, and what my API is going to look like. And so first you can see that this is using the Node.js 18 runtime. It's using serverless framework version 3, and it's created just a single function with one API. When I do a get against the root, it's going to call that index.js file that we were just looking at a moment ago. Okay. So let's just, before we commit this, I want to make sure that everything's working. So I'm going to go into that directory. Let's go into that AWS directory. And then I'm just going to do a serverless invoke and I'll pass it the function. This is this API that we have defined here. And I'll ask it to execute that for us. And it should come back and say, hello from Code Catalyst. Make sure that everything's working as expected. Give that a second. It's going to build the application behind the scenes and stuff. And then it says, as expected, hello from Code Catalyst. So everything appears to be working right. Let's therefore commit this. So I'm going to come back here and I'll just do a simple commit and push and have it take everything that I've changed, all the new files plus the ones that I've edited, and we'll push those in. We'll call this our initial commit. And I will save that. And then Visual Studio will push it. Give that a second to push the changes back to CodeCatalyst. Okay, and now if I come back into here, I'll just clean the screen up a little bit. I'm now back in CodeCatalyst inside that source repository that we created. And if we come to commits, you can see there is the earlier initial template that was created when I created the repository. That was just the README file. And then we've got the initial commit that we added about a minute ago. So everything seems to have worked properly. With that, let's move into the CI/CD conversation. So now that I've built my serverless application, I want to use CodeCatalyst to deploy that to my AWS environment. So I'm going to come in here to CI/CD. And the first thing I need to do is we need to go and create an environment. I need to tell it where I want to deploy this. All right, so I'm going to create a new environment to deploy this into, and I'm just going to call this dev. This is a non-production environment. I'll leave the description blank. And I've previously set up an account connection. An account connection is CodeCatalyst connected to one or many AWS accounts that you want to be able to deploy things into. So I've got one set up. And I'll use that one. Right, and this will take care of all the overhead of the IAM roles and things necessary to log in for me so that I'm not managing those as secrets within CodeCatalyst. Okay, so now that I've got an environment, we can come and create a new workflow. So let's do that. I'm gonna come in here. I don't have any workflows at the moment. I'll just create a new workflow. I'll store that back in the same repository. This will just be a YAML file that gets stored here. So I will create that. All right. And you can see here's the YAML that describes my very simple workflow. There are no actions created right now. It just has a source. And it is set up with a trigger to run this anytime someone pushes to the main branch. There's lots of other things I could do. These could be pull requests, or I could have wildcarded feature branches if I wanted to here. And it's very flexible how I set up my triggers. But let's use a visual designer. I think that looks better in a demo. Okay. And I want to add a new action. So first, you can see there are a whole series of CodeCatalyst actions that I can use. Everything that you would expect, things like build and test, as well as AWS specific things like ECS tasks, cloud formation templates, CDK, and lots of other things that I can do here. As you might expect, Serverless Framework is not one of those, being that it's not an AWS service, but CodeCatalyst is extremely extensible, and I can also use any of the existing GitHub actions, or the vast majority of GitHub actions anyway. All right, and we have curated a list of very popular GitHub actions that customers are using. In this case, though, I also don't have a pre-existing GitHub action for Serverless Framework, but that's okay. I can use any GitHub action. So I'm just gonna add this generic shape. And if I come into the configuration for this GitHub action, you can see right now it's just doing a hello world. We're going to change that to be a serverless framework deployment. The first thing I need to do is, though, let's go select that environment that we just created a moment ago called dev, right? That is going to deploy to my development account. And I need an IAM role here, which again, there's existing IAM roles. I'll just use this CodeCatalyst development role. Okay. And now, obviously, we don't want the Hello World application, but if we come over to the GitHub Marketplace here, there is a GitHub action for serverless deploy. And they've got a couple different examples. The one that I really care about here is this one. And what's important here is that this one is if your serverless function is not in the root of the directory, which it's not, because remember, we created a subfolder for our action. So now I can just very simply come in here and paste this code in that I got from the GitHub action marketplace. And I need to just tell it where my actual source code is. Where are you going to find my source for my serverless function? And it was in this folder that was created by the wizard that instantiated it. Okay, so that's all I need to do. I'll just validate this, make sure that everything's good. It is, so let's commit this. And again, I'm gonna commit this back into that same repository that we've been using. We used a visual editor, but behind the scenes, this is just stored as YAML within your repository. So I will commit that. All right, and give that a second to commit that back to the repository. And you can see now I've got this workflow. I probably should have renamed it so that it's more descriptive, but for the moment it's running. And if I come in, we can come in and look at this running function. All right, and I could click on this to see what's happening. Okay, and we can see again that my workflow has succeeded. And if I click on this, you can see what's happened. It has set up the action, it's built the GitHub action, and then it's executed code. And throughout, we've got all our logs. And then finally, I can come up and see this deployed application. So here it is. We've got hello from CodeCatalyst. It also included it reflects back all of the headers and other information that were passed as part of the request. Okay, so a quick review of what we just did. So the first thing we did was we created a new dev environment. All right, and we started with an empty repository. We created a dev environment and we installed Serverless Framework and used that to create a new project. Then we pushed it back into CodeCatalyst and committed it to our repository. Then we set up a CI/CD workflow to build and deploy that to AWS. So if you want to get more information and get started, talk to your account team. There is a CodeCatalyst deep dive workshop where you can get hands-on with this, or of course, codecatalyst.aws is the URL. You can just go there and you can start using CodeCatalyst within the AWS free tier. So thank you. Again, my name is Brian Beach. I appreciate your time today. Hope you enjoyed this presentation.